Seems to me, and this is not to take away from anybody else that participated, but when Nico came on board, the level of positivity just increased tenfold. And it's so nice to look over and see the two of you sharing that side of the stage.
I mean, stage right rules, you know. I mean, but yeah, with Nico on board, he's just been a friend for years. He was in Magpie Salute with us as well. And he's a great player and just a fantastic guy, and I love having him to my right.
His enthusiasm about that music and his reverence and respect for it, but then puts his own little spin on it.
I think that's the right approach, is to take, you know, to put yourself in the music, but put the music first. What Nico does fantastically is play the parts so that the song is recognizable. And when there's parts where you can put yourself into it, that's when you do it. You don't start it with an intro of a song and come up with a new intro. and you're right. He's his own player. So even if he's playing Mark Ford's or whoever else's part, he's playing them as Nico Bereciartua, and it comes across that way. But it still sounds like the Black Crowes, and that's what that balance you have to strike. I did the same thing when I joined the band, having to play Johnny Colt's bass lines. I try to stay as true to that as I can on the songs that I didn't originally play on, because that's how the song becomes recognizable to people, you know. So that's always been my approach as well. So,
State of America, hosted by two of the band's most dedicated fans, David Hudson and Ian Rice.